Anyways, I'm Vanessa Ann Miller, and I help network marketing mamas create a captivating personal brand strategy so that way they are attracting more clients and team members with ease and without the rejection. Today, I'm going to be talking to you about five myths of network marketing. We're going to debunk those myths so that way you can have one, re-energize your excitement in your network marketing business. Perhaps you have been in the business for quite some time, but the stigma around network marketing may have zapped your energy and confidence. So I'm gonna re-energize you with some tips, plus give you some talking points of what to say when someone rudely comments about you being a network marketing. The first would be that network marketing is a pyramid scheme. So people think that because you are paid based on the production of people in your downline, that it's a pyramid scheme. But the FTC defines a pyramid scheme, a true pyramid scheme, by basically if you sign people up with no tangible products that you're selling, no kind of service that you're selling, but you get compensated by just signing people up. They say network marketing or pyramid schemes promise consumers or investors large profits based primarily on recruiting others to join their program, not based on profits from any real investment or real sale of goods to the public. So what this is saying is that if you're just signing people up, just to sign people up, and you get paid based off of the fees, their enrollment fees, then yes, that is a pyramid scheme. When you compare a normal company to a network marketing company, they both have similar structures. A company that sells goods usually has a management position in place, and they have the people that they supervise, depending on how they manage and how they groom them and, you know, the sales training, then they get paid, they get a bonus probably every year or every quarter, depending on their compensation. That is just like what a network marketing business is. Your upline is paid to groom you, to train you, to make sure that you succeed. And sometimes they get paid some kind of profit from whatever you're selling. And the better the leader they are, obviously the more successful they will be, as well as their downline. Another point to this is that on the FTC website, they say that pyramid schemes, network marketing companies that are more pyramid schemes, they require that you buy inventory. I know a lot of companies do require that you buy inventory, but they're not necessarily pyramid schemes because you do get paid off of the products that you're selling. However, for those companies that are not requiring that you buy any excess inventory just to be a part of the business, that is a selling point when you're recruiting. You can say, look, you don't have to invest extra money besides your enrollment fee to get your discount. Your new clients can go directly to your website and purchase an order from there and buy direct from you, and then you get the profit. If number two, simply be a product of the product. Now, this kind of goes in line with those companies that want you to have excess inventory. They want to make sure that you're using the products. Obviously, you want to use the products and like them if you're going to sell them, and you want to get results so you can be a walking billboard. However, these days, more and more people are looking to brands that have a more personal approach. And so it's great to be a product of the product, but that should be implied. That should kind of be like the body language of your business. And you should be leading with a personal brand. Because 86% of consumers say authenticity is a key factor when deciding what brands they like and support. What does that mean? That means that, you know, if you're just showing up with your product selfies and doing everything else that other people in your network marketing business are doing, and maybe they're not necessarily as successful as you want to be, but you're copying them because maybe they have a lot of followers. That is not showing up as you, because really, how often are you going around, you know, with your product selfie? You know, that's not who you are. You are a unique person with individual talents, and you have your own personality, your own, you know, funness, everything. You know, you have your own DNA. And so when you are following what other people are doing and you're not leading with your gut and what feels good, then you're not being authentic. Can you imagine if you had a personal brand, how many more people will be attracted to you? Because when you're authentic, they get to know, like, and trust you. And people are going to buy from people that they trust. You know, 81% of consumers say that they need to be able to trust a brand in order to buy from them. And it takes a lot more time these days for people to trust us. There's a lot of white noise, a lot of people selling, and I can just look at my email and I see everyone that wants to sell me something. But whenever you come across as a valuable person that doesn't just want to sell, but that wants to educate and have a lifelong business relationship with someone, then you build the trust faster. And speaking about personal brand strategy, if you have your own colors, if you have your own look, if you have your own, just your own feel to your brand and the way you present your business, then you're going to be recognized a lot more. I have pugs. Well, now I have one recently passed away, but everyone would see it. When people see pugs, or they see like memes of pugs or videos of pugs, people will go and share that with me. People that I haven't met, people I really don't know. But what does that tell you? That when you have some kind of signature brand, or people are going to recognize that, it's going to be a subconscious recognition and they're going to think about you. So that is another reason that you need to have a personal brand. But myth number three is that your company marketing tools are good enough. No, because that goes back to what I was saying about having your personal brand. When you are doing the same things, talking the same talk, walking the same walk as everyone else in your network marketing business or company, then you're just Waldo. You're just putting on that Waldo turtleneck and you become lost in the sea of Waldos. You're not standing out. When I was telling you about my email, like, people are always trying to sell me something. You know, I have so many emails, just marketing emails. And whenever they're from network marketers talking about their next sale, their next product launch, or, you know, it just becomes white noise and I end up ignoring them. There's nothing that grasps me. And a lot of times they're coming directly from the network marketing website. You know, they're coming directly from the platform that the network marketing company gives them for free. And so when you're using those tools, like I said, it doesn't set you apart. In fact, people feel like they're a transaction. And so when you have consistent presentation that is apart from what your network marketing company provides, back to that personal brand strategy, then it increases your revenue by 33%. You are getting paid to be you, to be your most authentic self, to put in a little bit of work to set up your own marketing tools outside of your network marketing company. When you have your own personal brand, and you're marketing yourself apart from there, you're going to be able to attract more clients and team members with ease and less rejection. So 73% of consumers cite that having a customer experience is far more important than the product experience. And if you follow me on Instagram, I just posted it this morning. I love supporting women in network marketing, because if I'm going to buy shampoo, my vitamins from a store, a grocery store, why not support someone that is, you know, trying to support their own family? And so I like to buy from network marketing mamas. However, when they do not have a follow-up system in place, it does not make me feel good. Like, whenever they don't reach out, hey, how did that product go? Or they don't have some kind of email nurture sequence, then I just feel like a transaction. When I'm just getting those company generated emails, you just feel like a transaction. So it is very important that you create a customer experience beyond what is set forth from your network marketing company. When you get into your network marketing business, it's great that they, it's basically a business in a box. However, that is, that box is hard to break through. That box, when you are put, when you put yourself in that box, it's hard to really reach more people and build a fun, lucrative business on how you want to, on your personal brand, on your personality. And so I highly recommend putting a system in place where not only are you attracting people to you, so whether you are Katia Plant, Vanessa Ann Miller, or Jane Doe, they are attracted to you. And then your network marketing products are what come with you. You that's how they get the results that you, a product of the product, the walking billboard, that's how they get those products. But people, they buy from people that they like. And when it comes to recruiting people, people don't join your company, they join you. So it is important, so much more now in 2020 than ever before, to lead with your personality, your expertise, your own personal brand. Because people need to feel, one, that they can trust you. But then secondly, when you have a system in place where you are nurturing them, you're cultivating a relationship, they feel seen and heard by you.